Okay, everyone, it is time to get another Let's Play Long Play done. And, we are introduced to a very familiar and very iconic introduction that everybody knows of. Yep. Yep, you guessed it. The next Let's Play Long Play is of that of Banjo Kazooie. In my dedication to Rareware Games, and in addition to that, now to the countdown to Yooka Laylee. And most people know that because plenty of the old artists and some of the old artists and game designers from Rareware Games, including a popular well-known name, I think it's either Greg or Steve Males, who have formed this small company now called Playtonic Games, are now going to be doing another great 3D action platform and fun action platformer title that is going to be a very highly well done 3D graphic predecessor to Banjo-Kazooie. And I always love this musical and great introduction to the game indeed. It is so awesome and creative indeed. Anyway, it's time to get the game started. And I'm doing it in a very special way this time. But I probably won't have enough time to explain it before I check through this and, check through which file I decide to do here and everything else. I'm also going to be doing silly voices for the characters. This time around, for my commentary, I muted my computer so you wouldn't have to hear it. But anyway, this is what I was talking about in Diddy Kong Racing, the iconic egotistical heads return and the most iconic one returns with Gruntilda's castle. So let's begin, shall we?
Ding pat by the bench. Who is the nicest looking wench?
Why, it's Grunty any day. She really takes my breath away.
Yes, you're right. I'm rather proud. My looks stand me out from the crowd.
But there is this girl.
What do you mean? This cannot be. There's no one prettier than me.
Why, it's Tootie, young and small. She's the prettiest girl of all.
No, you must be mad. Nicer beauty can't be had.
Unfortunately, I think you'll find it's Tootie. She's cute and kind.
Well, we'll see about that.
Oh boy. Typical Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs introduction.
Hi there, Tootie. What are you going to do today?
When my big lazy brother wakes up, we're going on an adventure.
Wake up! I want to go on an adventure too! If Tootie thinks she's fairer than me, I'll steal her looks and ugly she'll be!
Is that your brother?
Where, Mr. Mole? I can't see him!
Up there, in the sky.
I don't think so. Who is that?
Come to me, my little pretty. You'll soon be ugly. What a pity.
Let me go, you ugly old hag.
Don't scratch and bite, my little bear. You'll soon need bigger underwear.
Oh no, she's got her. Somebody, help!
Banjo, wake up! Now!
Yawn, what do you want, Kazooie?
Let's get outside, there's trouble!
And yet, the very iconic adventure with the awesome witch laugh begins that everybody knows of.
Listen up, I'm Bottles, the short-sighted mole.
I'm Banjo, and this here's my buddy, Kazooie.
Sure is a strange-looking buddy, Banjo. Can it talk?
Better than you can, Goggle Boy.
What was all that noise about? Where's my sister, Tootie?
The ugly witch, Gruntilda, swooped down out of the sky and grabbed her.
Calm down, Geeky. We'll get her back. Where did she go?
She flew up to her mountain lair. It's really dangerous, so you'll probably need some training before you go up there. Press A if you want me to teach you some basic moves, or press B if you think you're already good enough.
We'd like some help, Bottles. What do we do?
Explore this area and look out for my molehills. Stand next to them and press B to call me. See you soon.
Anyone home?
Hello again. Let's start with the camera controls. They're on the yellow C buttons.
Jeez, that's not nothing special.
Try this then, Beaky. Tap R to move the camera behind Banjo.
Is that all worm breath?
No, hold R to keep the camera behind your feathery butt. Try it out. I'll see you at the next molehill.
And yet we'll get the next move as always.
Banjo, it's time for you to learn the claw swipe attack.
What is it? I must know!
Simply press B when standing still or moving slowly.
Sounds good! What can I try it out on?
Well, how about bird brain?
Just try it, Bottle Boy!
Only kidding. Let me find something with a challenge. Ah, there's Topper. Whack him, Banjo!
And a bear swipe to the and two bear swipes to the topper.
Wow, nice one. Try another.
Hey, I want some moves.
Now try my fearsome forward roll.
I want to learn to fly now.
Roll by running and pressing B. I'll see if I can find ball for you to practice on. Bullseye, one more.
Stop rolling, I feel sick!
It's time for the buzzard to learn a trick.
It had better be a good one, Squinty.
Try out the rat-a-tat rap by jumping and pressing B in the air. Now where's Collywobble?
Collywobble, cauliflower.
Not bad, Featherface.
Give me another, Bog Eyes.
as we fight vegetables as our enemies in Spiral Mountain.
You've learned all of the basic attacks now. See you around.
Okay, the unique thing about my Let's Play Long Play of this is, as you see, I'm not collecting the empty honeycomb piece. And I really won't be, because I'm actually doing a 5 honeycomb run of this in this Let's Play Long Play. And I'm also going to, hold on.
My beak barge attack needs the help of old chicken legs.
At least I've got some legs, short stuff.
Hold C and press B for a powerful beaky barge.
As we're now destroying some boulders.
See, Banjo? She is useful for something.
I'm trying this move out on you next, Jam Jars. Jam Jars.
Oh, man, that is so iconic, and most people know what I'm talking about when I mean that. Anyways, I was about to finish saying, I'm also not going to be obtaining any of the Cheato cheats in order to upgrade my feathers, eggs, and eggs in this Let's Play Long Play of it. So there's a challenge.
Hey, Banjo, I hope you're not afraid of heights.
I'm not. Tell me about flying, Root Muncher.
Not yet. Banjo, jump onto a tree, then use the control stick to climb up or down.
As we're getting...
You'll find plenty of other things to climb.
As we are gaining all the basic moves, and so I love a lot of things about this game, like so many other players that remember all the great memories to this game, including...
I'm sticky, tasty honey energy.
As with so many other players that remember, along with its with all the great soundtracks that are in Banjo Kazooie 2.
Fancy learning to swim underwater?
Oh, sounds difficult, and I'll get my fur wet.
Come on, Banjo. I want to swim. Spill the beans, Specky.
Use the control stick to swim on the surface. To swim underwater, press B to dive. Go on, give it a try.
While underwater, Banjo press A to kick his legs. The Winged Wonder can press B to use her wings.
Your jump could do with some help.
Ha! What do moles know about jumping?
More than you, press A to jump and hold it to jump higher. Come on, Feathers. You can give him a hand.
Why? I'll look silly. I know it.
Jump, then press A again in the air for a double jump.
That's it. We're ready to move on.
Not until you learn this one first. You must stand like this.
What? Wearing ridiculous glasses and a silly grin?
I'm not listening. Hold Z, then press A for the mighty flap flip jump. That's it. You've learned all the basic moves. Meet me at the top of the Spiral Mountain, and I'll tell you what to do next.
Okay, now that we have some breathing room, like I said, it's to The special mode that I'm doing it on will make the game a lot more difficult. Thankfully enough, most of the stuff in the game isn't way too difficult to deal with. However, there will be a few little segments in Banjo Kazooie that will be kind of difficult to achieve. But you might be asking to yourself, is it even possible to complete Banjo Kazooie with only 5 honeycombs? Well, the answer to that question is yes, and I've of course done it. Otherwise, I wouldn't be showing it to you.
Look out for me. I'm an extra life.
Okay. As we proceed on with the charming and still very iconic spiral mountain. As we climb up the literally awesome spiral mountain yet again to Gruntilda's lair.
Well done, guys. You're ready to tackle the witch now.
We sure are. Show us the way, Bottle Boy.
I've fixed the bridge so you can cross it and enter Gruntilda's lair.
Thanks, Bottles.
Look out for me inside. Good luck.
Thanks for that. In this case, I would need my luck. With the mode I'm doing this on. Oh boy.
This fine contraption, so I'm told, will make me young and tooty old.
Let me go, you fat hag! My brother will come and kick your butt!
Rescue you, he will not dare. There's many dangers in my lair. Hurry, Clungo, push that switch. I'm tired of being an ugly witch.
Yes, Mistress Grunty, power is on. Soon be ready.
Banjo, help!
Oh boy, don't worry, we'll save you.
There he is! The fun begins! My tricks and traps, we'll see who wins!
Hey, it's me, Mr. Jiggy! Now go and find a picture with my piece missing!
And yet again we see the awesome silly animation. We're collecting the very first Jiggy in the game. Wish they should have kept that silly animation for the sequel, in my opinion. It was great. Okay, and now we begin the first iconic level of the game.
To enter the world shown on the picture, you must fill in the missing spaces with the jigsaw pieces.
We've got the first jigsaw piece, Goggle Boy.
Great. To fill in the missing spaces on a picture, press A. If you don't want to use any jigsaw pieces, press B to leave. That's it. The picture's complete, and the door to Mumbo's Mountain is open.
That was such an easy fit. The others may just test your wit.
Oh no, they won't.
There are 3 new moves to learn in this world. Find my molehills and I'll explain.
Yippee! You saved me! Gruntilda has imprisoned 5 of us Jinjos on each world. Free us all to get a Jiggy.
I'm a note, 1 of 100 on each world. Collect us all to open the note doors.
As we begin the great adventure with the first little level, which always, as players know, is the easiest one to beat in the game. Thankfully enough, the beginning of the game, of course, is not going to be too hard or difficult, so I have to say that there's really nothing I gotta explain here. Anyway, it's so odd to me that the bulls in this game are called Big Butts. Go away, leave my honeycombs alone. Don't worry, we don't even need them.
Grr, this conker's tree be hit bare with oranges. Don't touch conker's blocks. Grr.
You must search for 10 of us on each world. We'll help you progress through the witch's lair.
And with that, I got the second jiggy.
When you're ready to leave this world, return to the start area and stand on the exit pad.
Chimpy hungry wants oranges now. Feed Chimpy.
Okay, you might be wondering about that. Well, I only did 20 minutes for each part. Okay.
Hey, that's Konka's orange. Put it back.
Yum, oranges are nice.
Oh, Chimpy like Konka's orange. Chimpy help Fat Bear and Bird.
Jeez. That's rather rude. They're not fat. Jeez. Oh, boy.
We're the eggs. Kazooie can learn to use us as ammo.
And we'll learn the technique right now.
Time for the buzzard to learn the ancient ways of the egg.
I'm listening, Beetle Braff.
Hold Z, then press the C button to shoot an egg out of your mouth.
Hey, sounds cool. Anything else?
Sure, press the bottom C button instead, and you can shoot them out from your behind.
Sheesh, sounds painful. I wish I never asked.
Bird Brain can carry 100 eggs in her backpack. Oh, and you can also use the control stick to aim while you are crouching. Exciting, huh? Now that you've learned to use the eggs, here's 50 to practice with.
And as players know, we don't actually me Mumbo token used for Mumbo magic. And as players already know, we don't have the move yet to activate that switch.
Me safe here. Bear can't hit Konga. Yarn, egg hurt Konga. Earn, bear beat Konga. Me give prize to bear.
And with that, that's a third jiggy down. I so love once we actually obtain the next move, because it makes moving around and it also helps so much for speed runners and everything else for this game, because it makes you move so much quicker within the game, awesomely enough. Even though there'll be points where you can't always use it, of course. But the majority of the time, you can of course use the move, and players no doubt know what I'm talking about when I say that. And with that, we collect jiggy number 4. There you go.
The Talon Trot will let Kazooie tackle steep slopes with ease.
That sounds useful. How does she do it?
Hold C, then press the left C button. Continue to hold C while moving Kazooie around with the control stick. Go practice.
And now we can awesomely climb up steep slopes. As I have to say, the talent drop is one of the most awesome moves in the game. As I'm collecting the eggs.
Yippee! You've collected enough notes to break the first note door spell. I call this the Beak Buster. Jump into the air and press C to send Kazooie slamming hard down to the floor.
Glump. I don't like the sound of that, Banjo.
Get used to it, Nest Girl. You'll be using it a lot. Whoa, Banjo, there's nothing more I can teach you on this world.
And now that we have the Beak Buster technique, we can now activate the switch. But first off, I'm gonna collect everything I can on this icon on the iconic looking stone pillars that are clearly a reference, because Rareware was a British company, to Stonehenge. And Stonehenge is what I said. Yeah. Nice. Collecting more notes, and soon we'll collect the orange Jinjo.
Jinjo! Do 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 wee!
I also lowered the game volume because, one, everybody knows what this game sounds like because so many people have, of course, played this, and it's one of the most popular Rareware games Rareware ever made. So it's a no-brainer that by now that you really don't need to have to hear the volume up in a loud kind of sense. And stupidly enough, I unfortunately had to get hit by Conga, but thankfully enough, I can easily get the health back. Smashing some huts. Smashing some huts. as we're gonna collect more eggs and no pieces. Take that, you stoop. Take that, you stupid enemy. And another Jiggy's down, and that's the first 5 Jinjos of the game collected.
We JoJo, Mumbo's totem pole, feed us with nice blue stones.
And with that quit so quickly, another jig is down. Ha ha ha! and get another one, cause of how so easy this level is, as everyone know, this world is, as everyone knows, bites the dust.
It's a bottom.
Hey, ugly! No bears allowed in Ticker's tower.
Man, and I gotta say that so many of the characters in this game are so dang rude. Yep, and we're introduced to a very iconic character that everybody knows of in the Banjo Kazooie series.
Me, Mumbo, best shaman in all game, can help Banjo and Filthy Feathered One.
Watch it, hot boy.
Mumbo's magic tokens hid by witch. Find tokens and Mumbo help you. Ah. Banjo has plenty tokens. Stand on skull and press B to see mighty Mumbo magic.
And as everybody knows, if you jump on one of the non-lit torch-like wooden poles that are in Mumbo's awesome hut, you actually can get some collectibles as you walk along the wooden support beams of the skull, as Mumbo's is turning us into the first animal of the game.
Mumbo's magic free to change back. You come when ready. Termite bit small, but not bad for first spell. Mumbo practice needed.
Hey, where do you get those shorts? I want them.
I always find this first part to be a bit of an annoyance. So if I wasn't able to come do this perfectly the first time around, unfortunately, it's because, yeah, the camera's kind of bad, but thankfully enough I did it the second time through, I'm happy to say.
Give me that cool backpack or else!
You found all 100 notes on this world. Well done.
Sorry about that. I think my throat's getting just a wee bit sore doing some of the voices and whatnot. and with that, and as long as we chance stay as the termite, we'll get all the jiggy, we'll get another jiggy in Gruntilda's castle, and also get another jiggy, and also have all the jiggies within the game. And of course, as I mentioned, we're skipping all the empty honeycomb pieces, because this is the 5 honeycomb run of the game.
Oh,
Gruntilda's Grunty's magic stops you from taking notes off the world, but the 100 you just collected counts as your best note score. Try to get 100 on each world, as they are needed to open the note doors.
Hey, where did you get those shorts? I want them!
Mumbo magic get weak. Animal turn back or magic go. Magic all gone. Must go back to bear and bird now.
When you open a world door, baddies escape and roam once more.
This is a note door, sealed by Grunty with one of her powerful musical spells.
Open it up then, Jam Jars.
It's not that simple. To open it, you must collect the musical notes from the worlds.
How many do we need?
The number on the door is the strength of the spell. The combined total of all of your best note scores from the worlds must be at least this to break Grunty's magic.
And thankfully enough, we have plenty of notes to break the magic from the first door.
That door was easy, you got past. Unfortunately, you're first and last.
Hello there, young ones. I'm Gruntilda. Gruntilda's nicer sister. I crept down here to help you defeat the old hag. It's about time she was taught a lesson. I know all of Grunty's disgusting secrets, and I'll tell you three of them every time you find me. Remember them well, young ones, as they will help you avoid a fiery fate. Press B if you'd like to hear them. Grunty brushes her rotten teeth with moldy cheese-flavored toothpaste. She also washes her hair with rancid milk. Yuck! And she gets her clothes from the trash can.
Yeah, that is pretty revolting, I gotta say, in every single sense.
To remove pieces that you have already put down, press the down C button. But once the picture is complete, all the pieces are stuck there permanently.
And the treasure chest opens to reveal the second world. that we all know that everyone that pretty much everybody who's played this game all knows of by now.
Your butt will tell you, and you'll know when my boot swings to and fro.
You've activated a magic cauldron. Find two of the same color to create a shortcut.
I only added that one word because I kind of felt like it needed it, because the way it was the way that was actually spelled was a bit grammatically incorrect, but whatever. There's a lot of grammatically incorrect speech within this game, because I think it was meant intentionally, because this was a kid's game. You know, because it's, of course, a very popular, well-known kid's game, as everyone knows. And I got to get hit twice by Grunty, the stupid minion. Yeah.
You've activated a magic cauldron. Find two of the same color to create a shortcut.
Even though I've already heard that already. And it need to be repeated a second time. And with that, we've got the second Mumbo token. And that portal will come, and that magic cauldron will come in handy later, as everybody knows, as I recovered my health and took down Grunty's stupid minions. And now, time to enter the second world, Treasure Trove Cove.
Ahoy there, this be Treasure Trove Cove. Thar be two new moves for ye to find.
Yeah, pirate talk, I know. But that's the whole theme of this world. And that is so awesome, I gotta say.
I'm a red feather. I'll help Kazooie fly when she knows how.
I know I don't do any, like, British voices, but I don't really think this is a game that really was intended to have full-on British accents or anything of that nature, in it, so, yeah. Anyway, if I didn't mention it already, okay.
Snacker smells tasty dinner. Stay just there.
If I didn't already explain this already, it's because, I didn't explain it already, it's just because I didn't want to deal with too many in-game lag issues, in case the new less definitional HDTV didn't fix up the lag issues from before. I think it actually did a pretty darn good job. There might be a tiny bit of lag in in-game play movement, maybe just a wee bit, but it's not too noticeable.
Hey, this is Nippers Beach. You'll find nothing without Nippers help.
Help us then, crustacean brain.
Cheeky bird needs feathers clipping.
Oh yeah? Just try it, shellhead.
Just be careful not to get pit. As everyone knows, just be careful not to get pinched.
Roar, you heard Nipper. Makes me mad.
And with that, Nipper is down. Oh, man. And I gotta say, this game is surrealism in every single good way. Indeed.
And I only got hit because Banjo grabbed the jiggy.
And with that, the first jiggy is down for Treasure Trove Cove.
And when are we there going to be dealing with more of ye pirate stuff?
Well, actually very soon, because right there, as everyone knows of, is the first pirate themed thing, Captain Blubber's treasure ship.
As we collect The musical notes by using the talent trot on these narrow walkways.
You'll reach new heights with my shock jump spring.
Does Kazooie do it? My legs are tired.
Don't worry, the turkey does all the work. Simply stand on a shock jump disc, then press and hold A.
Oh, I love all the goofy sounds that Banjo Kazooie make in this game. Like,
me licky, no good for water. Can bear block hole with pebble? Leaky patched up now. Empty water for bear.
Yep, and unfortunately you have to do this all the time whenever you enter this level, which gets a bit annoying, I gotta say, but thankfully enough that is one of the many things they fix up in the sequel, as everybody knows, having to sometimes repeat some of the same stuff yet again. Anyway, yes, like they always, okay.
Hey, Furball, you're looking wise. Solve my puzzle and win a prize.
And the puzzle is very simple to solve. I would believe any first or about second grader could solve this. Which there were probably plenty of when the game first came out. But now so many of the fans are somewhere around my age, to either being teenagers old teenagers to the point of young men and women or older.
The gates open to reveal your prize, but first I'll cut you down to size.
Oh yeah. There we go. And with that now the second jig is down. I had a different voice for Gruntilda, but I felt it was sounded a bit too similar to that of Kazooie. Anyway, if you're curious, Gruntilda actually, surprisingly enough, has a really nasty, low pitch kind of sounds when you're fighting her in her boss battle, and anyway, kind of similar to what I was sounding like. So I thought to myself, yeah, my voice sounds pretty similar to what Gruntilda probably sounds like, given that everyone says ugly, fat old witch.
Yeah. Oh, hi there, I'm Captain Blubber, and I lost me treasure when me ship crashed.
Well, go find it then, Blubber Guts.
Arg, but I can't swim, and ye help an old sea hippo?
Sure, we'll find it for you.
Mm-hmm. Now, I actually remember how, dumbly enough when, and I'm just being truthful, when my father used to own this game and, thought that the treasure was out there in the water where Snacker the Shark was, I thought to myself, I think to myself, oh, jeez.
Ahoy there, I be Blubber's treasure.
Yeah, geez, I don't think it would be that difficult. I mean, this is only a kid's game, for crying out loud. And actually, the treasure is just inside Blubber, inside a Blubber ship, as you can see with, logged with water, and it has been, and has now been crashed, near the semi-shallow water, kind of near the shore of Treasure Trove Cove, or the
island of Treasure Trove Cove. Me treasure, thank ye, me hearties, take this reward. I'm off to spend.
And it's not until the sequel, until we figure out what Blubber spend his gold on. And another Mumbo token down.
Walking up the master of the ship.
This is your big chance, Chicken Legs. Time for you to fly.
At last, it better be easy, Bog Eyes.
Simple enough even for you, Bird Brain. Just stand on a flying disc and press A. Here's 25 red feathers to help you into the air. See you. Nice going. You've learned all the Cove's new moves.
And this is what I gotta say is another awesome move indeed. And surprisingly enough,
okay, to fly higher, you'll need some red feathers. Press A to use one, but remember that Beaky can only carry 50 of them.
This be Gruntilda's booty. Touch it if you dare. That golden treasure was for me. Now harder still, the game will be.
Well, she's not joking about that for the much later levels. Yeah, I think it's so funny how those clams' names are Yum Yum. Yum Yum. Oh boy.
Yum 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 Yum.
Yeah.
Yum 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 Yum.
Oh man, this game is so great. It's so illogical to have a lighthouse on the top of this really high hill. I mean, what ship is even gonna see the lighthouse light from this high of a from this high of a hill with a gigantic stone archway? I mean, I'm just being serious. Oh boy. Anyway, those things are really more of an annoyance than difficulty, because if they do hit you, they'll start eating your collection of blue eggs and red feathers and stuff like that. And later, as everybody knows, gold feathers. Yeah. Oh man. I can't wait to experience Yooka Laylee and see so many of the great iconic things from Donkey Kong Country to even Banjo Kazooie. And now the second Gruntilda switch has been hit and the second Jiggy revealed. As we're soon going to get the next Jiggy on top of the lighthouse. And with that, that's the next Jiggy of Treasure Trove Cove down. We only have 5 more to go. Of course, only have 5 more to go. Now there's several ways to actually get down from here. I'm just gonna use the simplest way. You know, the way that of course won't cause the player to be in too much danger.
Yippee, Snacker gets dessert too.
I don't think so. Snacker. No matter how much you try, it might nip us when trying to get that one of the empty honeycomb pieces, and unfortunately get a little bit of substance. You'll never kill Banjo Kazooie. Jumping along, silly enough, jumping along the shock spring pads yet again, I collect the pink ginger of Treasure Choco. There we go. Okay. Taking a shortcut so I can jump on the top of here and collect the next jigsaw piece. Yes, but the reason you do the flip flap jump for those treasure chests is because if you don't do that, as you can see, Banjo and Kazooie actually can get hurt by their teeth.
Grr, I'm a fearsome looking lockup.
But as long as Banjo Kazooie flip flap jump into me when my mouth is open, I'm not that much of a threat. it's so funny and iconic, and I can't wait to see many new things in Yooka Laylee that will have silly googly eyes and actually be alive even if they're inanimate objects. Oh man. I know Rareware was made by a British company, so I know most people would say, hey, like Conker's Bad Fur Day, why don't I have more of a British accent for these voices? Well, in my honest opinion, I don't really think they really need it for a game like this.
Follow the clues if you're looking for gold.
Yeah, I didn't do that one as good as I should have, but oh well. Oh well. Oh well, thankfully enough, it was just a minor little enemy voice, so nothing too major. And with that, the seventh jiggy is found. Man, so many of these, I gotta still say, that so many of the worlds in this game are so well designed and are so awesome indeed. But if you're curious, this is actually not my favorite Rareware game. Well, Rareware game, and now some of the old creators, awesomely enough, becoming Playtonic Games. And I cannot wait to experience Playtonic's games, probably first really great and fantastic game, even though, obviously enough, some critics are probably going to give it as much recognition as it should deserve, because they'll say, oh, it's like a typical action platformer game we've experienced before, and it will be kind of the same way in some aspects to probably Sly Cooper, like that Sly Cooper was when the Thieves in Time game came out. Well, in my opinion, the old creators at Rareware always knew how to make great games without a doubt. And even though this is still not one of my most favorite Rareware titles of all time, this is still one of my most favorite Rareware titles of all time. But it's not really one of my most super all-time favorites of all time, really. Like that of Donkey Kong Country 2 is, as I've mentioned before. Okay, it's getting rather close, and around the 50-second mark, I'll say what I always do to end off the video part. This has been the Naster Chief 1, and I hope that you've enjoyed my Banjo Kazooie Let's Play Long Play 5 Honeycomb run with no Cheato cheat upgrades, as I'll complete the rest of Treasure Trove Cove and get on to then of Clanker's Cavern, and I will see you all in the next part. So pretty much see you all later, and goodbye as I continue the Rareware dedication and the road to Yooka Laylee. So, see y'all later, and goodbye.